What does this mean? Depending on our criteria for what constitutes likely or unlikely, if we get a sample mean in the critical region, here for a one-tailed test, or here for a two-tailed test, then we decide that most likely we did not get this sample mean by chance. Note that in the case of a two-tailed test, the z-critical values are the same used to calculate confidence intervals. Here, you're just applying the same ideas to different situations. When we do statistical tests, we'll set our own criteria for making a decision. In other words, we'll choose an alpha level. And then we'll decide that if the probability of obtaining a particular sample mean is less than that alpha level, then there's evidence of an effect. Usually we're going to stick with an alpha level of 0.05. At an alpha level of 0.05, we have two possible outcomes in either situation, one-tailed or two-tailed. Either the sample mean will lie outside of the critical region or inside the critical region. We notate these two outcomes as the null hypothesis, which we call H0 or H0, and the alternative hypothesis, H0A. Other ways of notating this could be H1, but I'll just stick with H0A for alternative. The null hypothesis assumes that there is no significant difference between the current population parameters and what will be the new population parameters after some sort of intervention. So we'll notate it like current population parameter mu is equal to the population parameters after the intervention. Where when we say equal, we don't mean exactly equal, we just mean they're not significantly different. The alternative hypothesis guesses that there will be a significant difference. Either the current population mean will be less than that after the intervention, or the current population mean will be greater, or that it'll just be different, and we don't predict a direction of the treatment. For the null hypothesis, when we're guessing that there's no significant difference between these two parameters, our sample mean will lie somewhere outside the critical region, in this white space. Note also that for a one-tailed test, the critical region could be on the left tail, not just the right. And the alternative hypothesis guesses that there is a significant difference, and that means that our sample mean will lie somewhere in the critical region.